In this video, I'll explain about moment of a force. After that, I'll derive the theorem of Verignon. First, we'll see what is moment of a force. The measure of turning effect produced by a force on a body can be called as moment of a force. For example, if you are applying the force on a door, then the door is opening or closing. That means that force is producing the turning effect. That we can call as a moment. So that means we can define the moment something like this. Moment of a force about a point or axis is equal to the product of force and the perpendicular distance of the point from the line of action of the force. So that means suppose you are applying the force somewhere here. This is the force. This is the point about which this force is acting. Then the perpendicular drawn from this point to this particular line of action of the force will be something like this. This is 90 degrees. The product of this perpendicular distance and this force gives the moment. So moment equal to product of force into the perpendicular distance. Okay, this is the force, this is the perpendicular distance. Then you will get the moment like this. What are the units of this particular moment? So this is not force, this is moment. So the unit of moment is equal to unit of force, which is Newton, multiplied by unit of meter. That means Newton meter is the unit of moment. How to identify the positive moment and negative moment based on the direction? Suppose when you are applying the force something like this about a point O, then this force is producing the moment in the counterclockwise direction. When the force is producing the moment in the counterclockwise direction, that you have to assume as positive. When the force is acting like this in the downward direction about this point, then this force is producing moment in the clockwise direction. Then we have to consider that as negative. That means the moment is in the anti-clockwise direction means it is positive. The moment is in the clockwise direction means that is negative. Theorem of Verignon states that the moment of a force about an axis is equal to sum of the moments of its components about the same axis. So to understand this, let us consider a force F like this. For force F, you take any two components like this. F1 and F2 are the components of force F. That means F is the resultant of these two forces. You can apply the parallelogram law like this. Then automatically this F will become the resultant of F1 and F2. Or F1 and F2 are the components of F. These are not rectangular components. You can notice this. These are the components at some angle. Then, now let us take a point O lying in the same plane such that we can take the moments about that point O. Somewhere here I am taking point O. Now I want to take the moments of all these forces about this point O. Okay. That means that point O is called as a moment center. Now attach two perpendicular planes in such a way that along this OA we will get the y axis and perpendicular to that y axis we will get the x axis. So along this OA I will take y axis and perpendicular to this y axis I will take x axis like this. Okay. Now this theorem of Verignon states that the moment of a force about an axis, that means whatever moment you are taking with respect to force F, is equal to sum of the moments of its components about the same axis. That means if you take the moment of F1 about O and F2 about O, and if you sum the moments of this F1 and F2, that will be equal to moment produced by this F. That is the meaning of this theorem. Now we are going to prove it. Now observe here. Assume that theta is the angle made by force F with respect to x axis. Theta 1 is the angle made by F1 with respect to x axis. Theta 2 is the angle made by F2 with respect to x axis. These are the angles. Then, if you draw a perpendicular from point O to onto the force F, this is 90 degrees. Perpendicular, here angle is 90. Okay, if you draw a perpendicular like this, then this perpendicular distance is some d. Then whatever angle you are having here theta, the same angle you will get here. This is also theta, because If the angle between two lines is theta, then angle between the perpendicular lines to those two lines will also become theta. So if you observe, this x-axis and this y-axis are perpendicular, then this force and this line is perpendicular. So the angle between these two lines is theta, means the angle between the perpendicular lines of these two lines will also theta. So these two lines are perpendicular lines to these two lines, that's why this angle will become theta. Okay, then moment of force F about O is equal to m equal to F into d, m equal to this F into this particular perpendicular distance d. Is it clear? Next, what about this d value? This d equal to, as this is theta, this particular d will become OA cos theta. If you take this particular triangle like this, then this particular d is the adjacent side. That's why this d value is OA cos theta. So F into d equal to OA cos theta. Okay, you take F inside this bracket, then this is equal to OA into F cos theta. This F cos theta, if you observe here, this F cos theta equal to, observe here, F cos theta equal to x component of this particular force Fx. F cos theta you can write as Fx, that is the x component of this resultant force. Moment of the force F is equal to F into d, that is equal to OA into Fx. You call this as equation 1. Now we'll find the moment of force F1. Moment of force F1 about O. Now draw a perpendicular from O onto this F2 line, onto this F1 line. Okay, this is again 90 degrees now. Then automatically this particular angle will become theta 1. Then moment M1 equal to F1 into this D1. Now D1 value equal to OA cos theta 1. So this D1 value I can write as OA cos theta 1. Now again OA you take out, then this will become F1 cos theta 1. This F1 cos theta 1 you can write as Fx1. Fx1, that is the x component of F1. This is equation 2. Similarly, we will take the moment of F2 about O. To draw the perpendicular onto this F2, you just extend this line. You are not able to draw the perpendicular directly, that's why extend the line and draw a perpendicular like this. This is D2. Then this angle made by this particular line will become theta 2. Okay. Moment M2 equal to F2 into this perpendicular distance D2. Then D2 again is equal to OA cos theta 2. This F2 cos theta 2 is nothing but Fx2, its x component. F2 cos theta 2 equal to its x component Fx2. Okay. This is equation 3. Take these three equations separately like this. The resultant force along the x direction Fx equal to sum of the x components of forces F1 and F2. That means this Fx equal to Fx1 plus Fx2. Analytical method says the resultant in x direction equal to sum of its components of all the forces along the x direction, that means Fx1 plus Fx2. Now multiply both sides with OA. You just take this OA inside, OA into Fx1, OA into Fx2. Now observe here, OA into Fx is OA into Fx, that is equation 1, that is equal to F into D. Okay, in this place we can write F into D. OA into Fx1 is nothing but equation 2. From equation 2 you can write F1 D1. In this place you can write F1 D1. OA into Fx2 is available in equation 3, that is this. So in this place you can write F2 into D2. This place F into D, in this place F1 and D1, in this place F2 into D2. So F into D is nothing but M. This is M1, this is M2. That means resultant moment is equal to sum of the moments of its components. So Varignan theorem is verified. I hope you can clearly understand the Varignan theorem by watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe to my channel.